Hi everyone, welcome to the sixth video in the quantitative methods course. In this video, I'll show you how to use two external packages in Stata to create nice regression tables and also how to make other tables, more specifically the descriptive statistics that you would need to report in pretty much every quantitative master's thesis. As I mentioned, we'll be using two external packages for this. These are specifically designed to make these kinds of tables. By default, Stata doesn't really offer much in the way of making your life easy in that regard. If you don't use these, or you would need to likely manually copy and paste things, so these packages are really nice. These are just two of many different options, but these are the ones I tend to use. Specifically, we'll talk about the estout command or package and the mkcorr package, and each of these do slightly different things. As we talked about in the first video, let's install these packages. In my case, I already have them, of course, so Stata will check them and confirm that I have them already. As you can see here, ssc install estout, I already have those. Ssc install mkcorr, already have those as well. And we'll load up the data set that we've been working with so far. I won't belabor these too much. We've seen these already in the prior video. These are the quality rankings that we had before in our regression model, and we are making both a numeric variable out of them, as well as you can see here, a set of separate variables for every unique value of the quality rank. Remember, this first one, for example, takes on 1 when this quality rank was an A. The second one takes on a 1 if the quality rank was A+, etc., etc. So first we're going to use the mkcorr command to create what they call the descriptive statistics table. So typically those would contain the average, the standard deviation, sometimes the range of the variables, as well as all the correlations between all the variables that go into your model. One thing to keep in mind, this tends to be for the sample that goes into your final regression, so you do need to be mindful of missing observations. But once we have this correlation, it will only be able to calculate that for all combinations of variables where there are no missings at all. So that tends to be what goes into your regression sample as well. The mkcorr command is structured as follows. You have the command itself, mkcorr, and these are the different variables that we had in our prior regression model. You might remember gross profits was the outcome variable, CH was cash, and we also have all those 9 separate quality rankings that we had before. The reason that we need to separate it like this, rather than use this quality rank variable, which was a single variable containing all the numeric values, is because Stata wouldn't recognize that these are all separate groups. It would just see it as a continuous variable. And then there's different options you can specify. There are many more, so you can check the help file for the mkcorr command if you want for more in-depth information, but this one will do the trick nicely. The log option here specifies what file you want to write it to. In this case, we're going to call it descriptive.txt. We use replace in case there's already a copy there. We will override it. We'll use variable labels as much as we can. So that's what this one does. If we don't have it, we'll just output the raw values. And we want to include the averages because otherwise it would just output the correlations. And mdec and cdec specifies how many numbers we want after the comma. This 3 here means that for the average and for the standard deviation, we want 3 numbers after the comma. And for cdec, it means for the correlations, we want 3 digits after the comma. And if we run this, you won't see any output here because it will have written something to a new file. And opening that up, you see here the output. So this by itself doesn't look that nice, but we can copy and paste this to an Excel file. So when we do that, you see here all the outputs that we need for a descriptive statistics table. So these all here are correlations, and this here is the maximum, minimum, standard deviation, and mean for our different variables. Of course, we can still clean this up a little bit more if we want. For example, this looks pretty ugly, so we could replace it with just something like quality rank equals A, or in Stata itself, we could have updated the variable labels if we had wanted. But in any case, this is pretty straightforward and saves a lot of effort from, for example, doing a manual correlation table. So we could do correlate all these and then copy and paste these and paste them into, Excel, and there's all kinds of possible room for error there. So the nice thing about this command is it just puts out the table for you in one go. So these are the correlations that I mentioned, right? So for example, this is the gross profit and loss, correlates 0.454 with cash, etc., etc. And you get all the required information for this descriptive statistics table that would really need to be in any quantitative thesis. Turning then to the estout command, I use that one to create regression tables. So first, of course, in order to do a regression table, we need to run some regressions. Let's just run one first where there's just cash in the model, and another one where we also include this quality rank. Here you see we use this this numeric version that we had before. This could also be those separate ones that we have, but this is just a little bit less error prone because we don't run the risk of accidentally maybe forgetting to put one of these in there. And we store those models as model 1 and model 2. Can be any name we want. And then we use the estout command. We say we want to have the outputs for model 1, model 2, so the ones we just saved. And we say using regression.txt. So this means, and it's before the comma, that we want to save these outputs using the file regression.txt. So this is a little bit different from the mkcorr, where this was an option with log. This is just because different people wrote these packages. But this is going to save a file called regression.txt, which will save the outputs. Here there's a lot of information, but I won't belabor it too much. The help file contains really a lot of specifics, but this means we want what we want to put in the specific cells. Here the B means these are the coefficients, so these are like in the left hand side here. This one would get saved, this one, those are the coefficients. We want to put the asterisk there for the p-values. So commonly, like I mentioned in prior videos and also in class, lower than 0.05 would be 1 star, lower than 0.01 would be 2 stars, etc. And this is some formatting. Specifically, this will say it's a number. We want to have it a width of 9 and with 3 digits. So if we replace this with a 2, it will become 2 digits, so it will round it differently. And then here you see SE, that's for the standard errors. So that's all these values that I'm marking now. Those are the standard errors associated with the coefficients. And we'll want to put that between parentheses. So the coefficients itself won't have any parentheses around it. The standard errors will. And that's all the output that you would typically see in a regression table. The coefficients, the standard errors, and then the asterisks associated with the p-values. Estout can also just output, for example, the raw p-values. Again, the help file for it contains all the information you need for that. But most commonly, you would just see this setup that I'll show you soon. We also want to save some statistics from the model. We want to save the adjusted r-squared. As mentioned in class, that's preferred to the standard r-squared. And we want to save the number of observations that goes into each model. Because we have seen already, once we include, for example, quality rank, the number of observations does change. This is some further formatting information for the statistics. So first we want to save the r-squared with 3 digits behind the comma. And of course, because number of observations is a round number, we'll specify we don't need any digits after the comma. The label here, we fill in r-squared, so it will output r-squared. If we make this, say, r-squared adjusted, it will fill that in for r-squared. And for number of observations, let's just add that as well. So this will look like this. We'll add a legend so that we know what it all means. We add the variable label similar to the mkcorr. In some cases, you might lose variables, so those would be omitted by the model. Let's keep those out. And we also exclude the base levels. In this case, this with the quality rank I mentioned in the prior video. If you have categorical variables, there will also be always one category left out. In this case, we won't show that because that will be empty. And finally, we can also label the variables manually. In this case, we're going to label this lower dash cons, which is the intercept or the constant. We'll just call it constant. So a lot of options. Again, the help file for estout contains a lot of extra information, but you can just tailor this one that I have here to your own needs, specifically replacing the models. Will lead to a pretty nice output that you could use in your assignments, but also in your thesis. So let's run this. You see there's already a file that I have there. So once we add the replace option, it's going to replace the file. So now we'll have said output written to regression.txt. And opening that one up, you see again, similar to this mkcorr, it doesn't look great yet, but actually we can just copy and paste this straight into Excel. And then you see here the outputs. Now, one thing you might notice, and that's something to keep in mind, the things that we have between parentheses, Excel is a little bit stupid in that regard. It will replace it by negative values. So if I type here between parentheses 1, it will make it -1. So what I would advise you to do, if you paste things into Excel, just make it text. So all the cells text, and then it looks good. So this is basically a regression table as you would see it in a quantitative thesis or in a paper. You can of course format it a little bit nicer, making borders, making labeling the models a bit better, etc. But this is essentially all you need. And again, this is much easier than going to this model and manually copying and pasting this value, copying and pasting this value, putting it between parentheses, etc. So this is much, much less error prone and leads to much nicer tables probably than you would manually do. So that's all I wanted to talk about for these two packages. Again, look into their help file if you want to see more information about these. These are really nicely documented and contain a lot of examples and illustrations. But what I've shown here and the commands that I'll put up on Canvas as well, those are all you need to make nice tables. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.